Morning. It is Saturday, March the 16th, 2024. And I'm out on the trail again, taking a morning walk. My kids are still sleeping, as teenagers do. They had a long week, so they deserve it. Today, I'm going to continue to do and what I always do in my boring existence, if you will. I will be more than likely at one of the three pillars of time killers that I'm involved in. That's, of course, the trail or park, where I do walking, running, or just sitting around and meditating or whatever. And then probably go over to the library later on today. That is quickly becoming a new favorite of mine. I have some, it's Saturday, it's not a work day, so I won't be doing any work other than some planning for a trip that I have coming up in June. Probably also looking and researching some other places, as I said, that I want to do across the country with traveling with some discount airlines, as I did last year on Frontier, and how I do that, how I travel out of a backpack and keep things very minimalistic and low budget at the same time. As I said, I am slowly developing these skills so that the next chapter in my life, I can squeeze the most life out of my existence. So, and that's at least the way I see it now. And while I'm on that topic, I wanted to cover what my, I guess, plans are for the future. As I said, it's very difficult for me to plan my day now, let alone my future. But, because we never know what the future will bring or whether or not we'll even have one. But we can plan on while we're alive. The one thing that we can plan on is that we're getting older. Can't escape that. And there are certain changes that come along with getting older, and we can't escape that either. We might be able to slow it down here and there, but by and large, we're all gonna get old, and if we're lucky, we're gonna die of old age. But this point in my life, in my mid-50s, I have kids in senior high school, I have a mother with dementia, my father has passed away. I have a brother, an older brother is only about 3 or 4 years older than I am. And I have other family, aunts, uncles, cousins, and so forth, but we're not that close. We don't stay in close communication. So I can see a time very, very soon, certainly within the next 5 or 10 years, where, you know, life is going to happen. And the kids will move out. My mother may not be here any longer. I'll be on my own, as I have been for the last 10 years. As I mentioned, I think in earlier videos, I don't plan to remarry. I enjoy my own company. I am not afraid of dying alone like a lot of people are. I figure we all have to die alone. Even if you're with somebody your entire life, you can't take them with you. They don't die with you. They might comfort you in your final days, but you know, if you don't think you need that kind of thing, you can comfort yourself. And, you know, it's a pretty crowded world. There's always going to be somebody around to comfort you. People are good, and they don't have to be lifelong partners to show you humanity. So I'm not too concerned about growing old and dying alone. So as I grow older, I want to keep in good health, and I want to, I don't want to retire necessarily. I want to always have something, some sort of employment that I enjoy that services the lifestyle that I want up and to the point that I want. I don't want to get myself into the trap of needing or wanting a lot of things. That's part of the experience, what I'm doing now. And I have been doing really for at least the last decade since my divorce. I don't need a whole lot. And as I grow older, I'm going to need less. That's my plan anyway. So as I move into older age and my kids move out of the house and I find myself more independent, more free, which are good things as far as I'm concerned. Obviously, I'll still be in touch with my children over the phone, but they're going to move on and have their own lives. They're going to start their own families. I'll be involved with that from time to time, I'm sure. But I know growing up, when I left home, my brother left home, you know, we only came back to see our parents a few times a year at holidays and so forth. We talked on the phone frequently. That's a far cry from the chapter in my life that I'm closing now, where you have kids when they're young, they need your constant attention. Life is a lot more hectic, it's faster paced, and I know going forward it's going to slow down. So I'm trying to move gracefully into this next period, and I'm trying to not only accept it, but look forward to it. What choice do I have? As I say, we're all growing older. You can't slow down Father Time. So I guess that's my message for this walk this morning. I'm going to continue on with this walk and on this trail, and I'm going to hopefully catch up with you later. I don't know what the day is going to bring. I might have to get my son's car serviced, emissions, and oil change. Might have to do the same for my car in terms of oil change. And that's pretty much it. We'll see where the day brings us. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye. Well, here's something interesting. I've been on this trail at least 100 times in the years past, and I've never seen this. This is about 50 yards off the trail, and I look up to the left, and pretty indescript, not very exciting, right? But to me, I need to explore this. So obviously, it's a man-made underpass of some sort for the creek here. But to me, it almost looks like a cave, right? I love caves. And that just reminds me, I've got to go visit some caves that I've experienced in the past and show you them, because there's some really cool ones here in North Georgia and Tennessee and Alabama that fascinate me. And at one point, our ancestors lived in caves. Hell, I could live in a cave, I think. Maybe not right now, but a little more deprogramming, and who knows. But let's go check it out. This is going to be interesting to navigate. That's where those squats come in handy. Need to be careful, don't want to twist an ankle. Excuse the profanity. It's dark. I can't see what I'm walking on. Probably not smart. Hopefully I'm making enough noise. Any snakes in here? Why did I have to say snakes? Now that's in my head. Oh well. Okay. I can see the light at the end of the tunnel. Alright, well. Shit. Get my shoes on, buddy. It's okay. I can clean them. Somebody's been through here. I'm not the only jackass. Well, good thing I didn't come down that way. Okay. We going to jump. There we go. Made it. Wow. Some more. Another one. I'm not going back the same way I came. Okay. Steep climb. Okay. Very steep climb. One of these trees.
Shoes didn't get too muddy.
That was fun. Actually, a little mini adventure. I'm a strange bird, huh? Stopped here for a coffee.
Cheers.
In a small town, and they are, even in this coffee shop, they have a bar. Probably around 50 beers on tap or so. And they're totally geared up for St. Patrick's Day today. Duh, right? It's Saturday, it's the 16th, but obviously, you can't get blood wasted on Sunday and then go to work the next morning. So I think a lot of people are celebrating St. Patrick's Day today. So cheers and happy St. Patrick's Day to all you one day a year Irishmen and all you Irishmen. Enjoy the day. Hope you have fun. Hope you do it safely. Library time. Okay, we killed a couple hours at the library. Now my son called and we're gonna go take care of his car. We're gonna get his emissions inspections that are required to get his tags renewed for the year. Get an oil change and probably have a meal. And from there, I'm not sure, but I'll probably work my way towards the gym. So, talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
What's wrong? It says there's an evap leak is what's causing it. We would have to run a diagnostic to find out exactly what it is.
Yeah.
We do this diagnostic for $7,850. And Sam would take a look and find out exactly what's wrong with it. And then, you know, let you know what needs to be done.
It's a weird looking dog, isn't it?
That's funny. Okay, it's evening and we're back at the LA Fitness for another workout and shower and sauna. So looking forward to this. But before I do, let's review the afternoon. I did take, as you can see, my son out to get the emissions tested and also an oil change. We made a trip to the car wash for him, to McDonald's, and also the auto parts store. So quite a busy afternoon. He is off with some of his friends now, so I have a chance to spend some time in the gym. Emissions didn't pass. It was a small computer error code, and we think it's due to an old gas cap. The car's 20 years old, and it's causing the sensor to go off. So that's why we stopped by the auto parts store and bought him a new gas cap. But we're going to have to disconnect the battery, run it for 100 miles so it resets, see if that works. In the meantime, we'll get a 30-day extension on his emissions, or his tag, to get that fixed. Otherwise, if that doesn't work, it'll be, you know, some sort of repair, which we don't know how much that'll cost, but I don't think it's that at all. So we'll have to do that, but it's good to find that out now. One of the things at the auto parts store that I also bought him that I also use and I think is good for everybody, whether you're living out of your car or not, to have is a battery pack or a brick that also jump starts your car in a pinch. It holds a heavier charge than what you would normally use for something like your laptops or your phones or things like that. People carry that around. I have one of those for my laptop that I carry with me all the time. But I also have one for my car that will jump my car. And I've used it many times for this car. I've used it for the minivan when I had that, as well as the car I'm going to give to my daughter. And so while we're at the auto parts store, you know, my son doesn't have one in the vehicle, so I bought him one of those. I would recommend everybody have one of those. And say you never needed to jump a car, which, by the way, you know, if you do need a jump and you're in a bad spot and there's no one around, what are you going to do? You can call AAA. We have AAA that we can call, but that might take 2 hours for them to come, maybe more in a remote area. Plus, you know, at night in a bad place, you don't want to be asking total strangers to help you jump your car that you're stranded, especially for women out there. So definitely invest in one of these. And if you, like I said, if you don't ever use it to jump your car, at least you have it to charge your laptop. Use it as a regular power bank. It has USB-C and USB connections to power all of your electronic devices, and it's safe for them too. So definitely look into one of those. So that's about it. I'm gonna, as I said, the day is winding down. Again, I hope everybody had a wonderful day. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your evening. Celebrating St. Patrick's Day today, please enjoy, but be careful. And I will see you all tomorrow on St. Patrick's Day. And I hope you all have a wonderful evening. Take care. Good night. Bye-bye.